Why do economists disagree so much? We are told that price is determined by supply and demand. There are some differences in how we approach this analysis. What Friedman is arguing is there is some central tendency in economics and there's noise. And what we should really focus on is what he calls the long-run equilibrium. And Samuelson, for example, calls the short run an arena of auxiliary constraints. And the exam question for economists was, tell us what determines the natural price. And so Smith and Ricardo, in setting the exam question for economists, telling us what it was our job to build theories of to attempt to determine, they didn't use the same theory for, if you like, their short run and their long run. We put this thing together and eventually we get to the end. And Gerard de Breux and Ken Arrow in the late 40s and early 50s demonstrate that prices can indeed be determined in what we can call a general equilibrium setting as a relationship between utility maximization subject to constraints of endowment and technology in a perfectly competitive economy. That's the core of economics. But this core came into some sort of conflict, some conflict with reality. And so what developed through the 1940s and 50s and 60s were a series of models, a catalogue of models. So that was one area which seemed to produce discord amongst the economists. Simply, whether you look at long run or short run, and which page of the catalogue of short run effects you choose. And these three people produced what has become known as the Sonnenschein-Mantel-De Breux theorem, SMD, the SMD theorem. And what does this theorem say? You cannot actually derive a well-behaved demand curve like this one in a general equilibrium model. And so what happened after that was the development in response to what Lucas had said of a new approach to supply and demand. And particularly the development of the so-called real business cycle models, and in particular the DSGE models. So how did these DSGE models work? They assumed there was only one individual in the economy, a representative individual. And yet what we have is a theoretical core which we either don't use, or we modify to take away from its essence, or we don't believe in. And so economists disagree.